Hey gameheads, the first person shooter genre throws gamers face first into a massive combat sequence that when done right is a thrilling experience. In mobile, most FPS games are mostly online multiplayer, but today, let's talk about 10 offline FPS mobile game titles for Android and iOS devices. First on the list is a pretty old game, Major Gone Z, an old title that still brings decent borderline graphics and arcade gameplay to the table. Engage in combat against terrorist cells and psychopaths as a brave commando and blast your way through diverse enemies with easy shooting controls. The game has satisfying FPS combat with combos and headshot bonuses, an intensive armory of dozens of weapons and loadouts, and different interesting bosses and locations. There are over 100 levels to complete with a PvP mode and a survival mode to further add to the fun. Number 9 is Zombie Poly, a polygon first-person shooter that lets you take down hordes of the undead with cool-looking weapons. From flamethrowers to Tesla guns, arm yourself to the teeth and go on missions to annihilate zombies in a world gone wrong. The game has decent polygon graphics with easy FPS controls where you point and shoot undead with your weapons. Lots of campaign missions to complete that feels very repetitive, very fast, and dozens of weapons, locations, enemies to keep you engaged. In the end, it's a pretty decent offline game to pass the time with. At number 4 is a horror survival game, Endless Nightmare 4. As the fourth installment to the Endless Nightmare series, you play as Scott, a veteran soldier trapped in a mysterious prison filled with ghosts and terrifying creatures. Explore this scary place, hide from or fight the roaming creatures in it, and uncover clues on how to get out. Feel the cruelty of reality and the helplessness of Scott as he finds relief and self-healing in this scary journey. The game offers a bone-chilling experience for horror fans, coupled with decent graphics and smooth gameplay and boss fights with gruesome and grotesque bosses. At number 7 is a Polish polygon FPS sniper, Sniper Mission Mafia Journey. A really simple yet engaging and fun shooting game where you play as a veteran sniper, take out criminal scum and mafia bosses in thrilling short missions that often test your ability to make swift decisions in crisis situations. As I said, the game is really simple with easy aim and shoot control mechanics, colorful and decent graphics, and an upgrade system that lets you better your favorite sniper. At number 6 is The Fall, Zombie Survivor. A recently released game, you play as a lone survivor exploring and scavenging the wreckages of a post-apocalyptic world filled with mutants and zombies. The game submerges you in a spooky and unsettling environment with dark-toned graphics and eerie sounds. You first start off with a bow, then other shooting weapons like handguns, automatics, and whatnot. As you progress through the wreckage of the city, exploring spooky sections for loot and necessary resources to survive, all while keeping an eye out for mutants and uncovering a streamlined plot. All in all, it's a pretty unique and interesting mobile version of something like Resident Evil series, and even though it's paid, it has a free demo to try out before buying. At the 5th spot is the OGM Lone Wolf. In the game, you play through the eyes of an ex-special ops sniper turned gun for hire as he embarks on his latest series of assignments that uncovers a beautifully stitched plotline. The striking detail of the game is the physics-based shooting mechanics where your bullets are affected by wind and other conditions, giving you an immersive sniping experience that's hard to beat. There are tons of missions to complete, an engaging story of a veteran soldier, engaging difficulty and tons more. Yeah, it's an amazing game that is old but still very much enjoyable. At the fourth spot, we got Elder Scrolls Blades. While not technically an FPS game, the Bethesda giant made mobile still brings an interesting first-person perspective to fantasy and sword combat. In the game, you play as an exiled blade who returns to his hometown in ruins, literally. So, it's up to you to build it from scratch by completing quests, exploring dungeons, defeating enemies, you know, the whole RPG package. The game brings really fine character customizations with cross first-class turn action, beautiful graphics, an interesting open world, multiple enemy types, and an engaging battle mechanic system. Overall, it's a pretty interesting game that is a scratch on the itching desire of most RPG lovers. Number 3 is The Sun, Key of Heaven, a nice-looking successor to The Sun Origin. Key of Heaven expands on this post-apocalyptic world destroyed by the sun, with better graphics and smoother up-to-date controls. Play as Raven as you explore a wasteland of a planet, completing quests, fighting mutants and other hostile factions. The game has a Fallout vibe to it, which I find pretty endearing and fun, and while the graphics may not be breathtaking, it offers tons of stuff such as its own history, hundreds of tags, a huge arsenal of weapons and armor, trade, fighting factions, mutants, bandits and prowlers. Explore the world with a huge number of locations and lots more. Number 2 spot goes to Bright Memory, a simple masterpiece that brings next-gen graphics to mobile devices. The game, as I said earlier, offers mind-blowing graphics with optimization that's off the chart. Made by indie developers, the award-winning title also brings immersive combat sequences that lets you switch from gun battles to melee combat seamlessly and smoothly. The game also brings a really good story filled with immersive combat and cool finishers coupled with pretty engaging boss fights. It is a near-perfect game that would have taken the number one spot if not for its incredible short overall duration. At number one spot is Gunfire Reborn, an epic roguelike with amazing polished graphics and interesting characters. As a first-person game, it brings smooth, immersive gameplay, and as a roguelike, there are fun bosses to battle, dozens of enemies to encounter, a perk system, a magic system, and all that fun stuff. It also boasts of multiple heroes with diverse skill sets and abilities, multiplayer fun with up to 4 friends, and dozens of amazing weapons ranging from guns to crossbows, spears, swords and lots more. It's a pretty unique and fun game, especially if you like fast-paced action and roguelike mechanic. Okay, that's it for today's Powering List. What first-person shooter game will you be checking out? Let me know in the comment section and please like and subscribe. It's your host, P-Duck. Thanks for watching and I'm out too.